Hello everybody, my name is Scott and I'm one of the Dirt Chimps, and today I'm out on the Buck Hills Trail. Once again, I was just out here a few days ago, but today I'm with a different motor buddy and I'm on a much bigger bike. This is the KTM 1090 Mongo that I've been riding for the last 4 years. This thing is awesome. It's huge, it's heavy, it's very powerful. She's a rocket ship. And it's gonna be a bit of a handful today. Let's get rolling. My motor buddy Dennis is on a 690. And he's leading today. Coming right up, this is a good indication of what the rest of the ride's gonna be like. Lots of rocks. Not a very well traveled path considering how good it is. It is quite remote. We're way out there. It's about an hour to get here from town. Dennis is already getting the good stuff up ahead. Hang on everybody. It's coming. Look at that, hey? Amazing. Yeah, I gotta remember, 1090, big, big bike. Look ahead, gauge the core, gauge the smile. Starts to go down, get away from it. Just let her go. Trying to get the shot to Dennis here, but my first priority is going to be keep myself safe on my own line. Yeah, sweet, hey guys? What a great trail. This is a difficulty 4 on our 6 level system. So for a big bike, this is getting near the top of what I would do. It's really maybe more of a 3+, but because it's so remote, we decided to give it a nudge to make it a 4 and maybe discourage people from, you know, maybe don't make this one of the first hard roads to try out. If I may say a few things about the beautiful 1090, I would say that it is great on the highway, even with a passenger, full luggage, lots of power, good wind protection, an absolute missile. It slays haul roads like you wouldn't believe. This thing is a party on the resource roads. You can do single track. It's a big, long, heavy, top heaviest bike though. You gotta be a little bit taller to touch the ground. I am not. Things get dodgy, I jettison from this thing, just let her fall down. We'll need to upgrade the suspension, because it's not tuned all that. Go for a spot cross.
This fucking thing stalls so much, it's unbelievable.
God damn it. I'm gonna have to beep him. To bleep him. He's got a stalling problem. That is frustrating. So if you get a 1090, you take it off-road, you're going to have to beef up the suspension. I'm only 160 pounds right now, and fairly aggressive, I guess. That's fine. And it was too soft for me. Yeah. Gear it down, like you said, all bikes. If you're too tall, this thing will still do, well, hey, I'll tell you, it'll do 180 on a dry lake bed. Road is close. we're not going to be going in to see the lake. We're not going to go to the summit. We are pressed for time. Dennis has a little dog. He's home alone. We are doing a little turnaround maneuver, so while I wait for Dennis, here's my bike. Storage up front, tools, tire repair stuff between here and the other side, extra crash bars, bark busters, cool little lights. Got one of my Kriga things on here with all my safety gear. My Silky's on the back, tied in so it doesn't rattle out. I'm not running the Kriga on this, but I'm having trouble with it rubbing right here. I'm working with Steve from Kriga right now to resolve that. Stag pegs, Moscow tank bag, and back up here for the other giant loop pouch. Like a bomber.
Oh, it goes that way.
Yeah, you go right up there. Cabin, eh? Cool. Okay, bye, cabin. Saw handy, we can just blast that. We'll fall over bike.
You got your saw handy?
Yeah. This was logged since Tuesday. That's why it didn't look familiar.
Well, if we just cut that top one, we can get over the bottom one.
Alright. Hey, you guys want to see my map? We started over here in Vernon. And we're going into Greystokes. We're going to come up on Highway 33 down by Kelowna. Yeah! Come on, baby! Whoa! It's fairly funny just to watch me on this bike because it moves me around. I don't move it around. Into a whole bunch more logging damage because we don't have time to be cutting a whole bunch of stuff. We don't have energy for that. If you're watching this video and you're like, hey man, I'm gonna do this road and the adventure bike gathering in a few days or next year or whatever, just know that this quote unquote hard stuff goes for a long time. For a lot of it. Like 15, 20 kilometers. It's a lot. You're gonna need to have some decent technique or some endurance or something. Uh-oh, what are we looking at here, guys? Why did you hit the biggest rock possible? Well, that was the best pass. It's actually quite easy.
Oh man.
Here we go. than it is, right? Like I say, I'm gonna go around on the right here, that's good, because I really don't like mud. I like it the least on this bike, the big bike, on the furthest on the ground. There we go. When I was riding this on Tuesday or Wednesday this week, I was often picking the hardest lines to make it spicy, because I was on my smallest bike. What freaking gear am I at? Just flying. Trying to garage bus here, right? I could use a lower gear. Some big rocks. It's bumpy. Well, usually I'm able to pick up with where I left off in my thought process, but not really now. It's all-encompassing. That's a handful on the big bike. Clutch finger tired, that's not a good sign. Way too early for that. I'm gonna put two fingers in the clutch soon. Or just get off the clutch. But if my bike wants to march ahead at a speed faster than I want to go, I'm either gonna get on the clutch or channel Kyle Pullman number 55 and look further ahead. Just go, man. You're gonna have to go faster. Really hard to bounce the front end of the 1090. So I'm missing my riding buddy Andrew today, aka Swag. He's got a little chiropractic related injury. Chiropractic could help him out. Hopefully he can get well in time for the gathering, right? You missed that. You're the cork. Like this on the route, on any route, try to relax. I have to sometimes just check myself. Am I death gripping right now? Am I doing anything that is spending more energy than necessary given the train that I'm in at that time? Like this, I'm just gonna freak down right here. I gotta be on, switched on. Okay, switch off. Oh, I just let the blood flow into my hands, arms. So cool. How's the camera angle today, guys? I hope it's high enough, not too high. Look at this. Oh, yo, 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 yo. Stop the mare. No fun to get going. Alright. I'm relaxing. Okay, switch on. Good God.
God, man, what have you brought me out to do? There's how much of this? Maybe you're saying, I gotta ask more questions before I go out and ride. Stop. Oh, that's a rolly log. I don't like that one. I'm gonna shoot for that gap. Shoot the gap, at least my front tire. Good. For the lake, guys, definitely go down there if you have the time. Walk it if you're finding this difficult. Walk that one. Okay, hang on. Noise, 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 noise. Big smile on the inside. Oh. Take a break. See, this stuff is tough, man. Let's go walk it. Need a little break. That's not a bad idea. Bring your spot, guys. Spot in reach. See lots of rocks. It's spicy in here. Yeah, I got a new helmet. Yes, I got a new helmet. I got a new shirt. I got new pants. It's my fall collection, as you would call it. And it's because all my summer stuff is starting to get pretty ratty. I've got a lot of days in. And it's very, very breathable, the stuff I wear in the summer. So it doesn't last as long. It's not summer anymore. It's getting a little cooler. So I got the new stuff. Oh, okay. I don't really like that I had to stop, but... Okay, what's the path here? It's kind of up the middle. Kinda. I think it would have been smart to maybe have another person on this ride. No, just in case. That was a pretty good riding, guys. Okay, we're rolling again. Right on. I put the spot up and down. It sends and receives a lot better that way. And I sent a little thing that says, hey, we're okay. We're still cruising. So wifey and Andrew back in town just got a text and an email with my location. I believe it's my location. As well as a note that says I'm fine. If you guys don't have one of those yet or don't pay for a subscription, you go out by yourself. Absolutely. Hey, I'd say it's an absolute must. If you go out in small groups, man, it's still super important. If you go remote like this, you gotta have it. You're a big dummy if you don't have it. If you've got a $10,000 bike, no
no spot, you're silly. Okay, that's enough of you preaching. Dennis's bike has been taken through this section. It's tricky, man. This is hard stuff. I am to be reprimanded for coming out here and without more people on a rather difficult route with someone I've only ridden with twice. Probably too hard. Consulted Gaia, my GPS program, and we still have a ways to go. Uh-oh. 40. Should have got an earlier start. Yep, deal with it. You get out there and you go on your adventure and you deal with it. It's not over until everyone's home safe. Hope we pass all the hard stuff and let the rest go smoothly. Hey, I could try doing one of those brutally honest review style things about this bike. About the 1090, a brutally honest review. Oh, there's Dennis. I bought it to go on little adventures. I didn't know what adventure biking was all about. It was relatively new at the time. I went on my first gravel road and went, holy crap, this is way cooler than I thought it was going to be. And I was terrified going on gravel at first, even though I'm a dirt biker. Took me a while to figure that out. Took the training with Chris Birch, that really helped. That really helped. Just getting comfortable on a much bigger beast. Anyway, brutally honest review. It's heavy. It feels heavy. There's a difference between being heavy and feeling heavy. This weighs exactly the same as our Triumph 1200 Scrambler. This feels way heavier. Our KTM 790 weighs, I think it's 10 pounds lighter. This feels way heavier. It's where the weight is, it's the height of the seat. Who knows? Math. Cockpit geometry, awesome. Great on the highway. Great at high speed, like I said, on the lake beds. Really fun on double track and single track. An absolute party on gravel roads. Not as fun as the Scrambler. Scrambler, nothing beats the Scrambler on haul roads. I'm not saying it's the fastest. Nothing beats the fun factor. Let's see. It just does not like the jump. It does not like the wheeling. Doesn't have enough suspension for sustained, really hard poundings. 790 loves to jump, loves to wheelie. What else? Great for two-up riding. Like, really great. Hull's luggage, great. Spicy section. Hope Dennis is doing okay. In his frame, talk himself out of a dark place. You guys know what I'm talking about. If you've had a rough ride, or you've gone off your bike, you've had an off or two, or you're maybe getting tired, it's not where I wanted to go. You know you have to talk yourself out of it. You pick yourself out of that bad mojo place. You try to put the smile on again, right? Sometimes you force yourself to smile. Fake as it feels. It'll help. You need a couple confidence boosting things. Do a hill well. Straight line. Philosophy of use. That's what he is.
as wide as it does. I told you about the weight, it feels heavy. Hey, that's it, what else am I gonna say? I'm out here, I'm having fun. I chose this bike over all the others for today because I wanted to do this trail on this bike. I also want to come back on through the scrambler. I think this would be about the limit of what can be done on the scrambler. It actually has more suspension than this bike, but it's the rest of the bike. Okay, let's pause and I'll see you guys in a minute. Alright, we are rolling. Dennis just gave me shit. But he's nice of us. We're laughing. We're gonna be friends still. Wolf cookies, which are homemade energy bars. I've got two of those Stinger gel pack things that are either 100 or 150 calories. Those things go through that energy pretty quick. The wolf cookies are really good. They're like 400 calories. They're great. But I didn't bring extras. You know, that's kind of what I thought I would need. I should have brought what I thought I would need plus a couple of extra. And then I should have added a couple extra again, because I'm with someone I don't know, and I don't know if they're going to pack enough food. Pack a little bit of food for the other guy, too. I got luggage, man. It's not like I'm going ultralight today. So, shame on me again. Shame. No joke, folks, this is a harder run than I remember. I was on a 501, come on! Easy, everything's easy on a 501. The 501's the bike that I'll go on when I'm going with some hotshot like Brandon Superstar, and he says, hey, I got a trail you gotta try out. It's awesome. It's probably gonna be pretty hard. He's a very fast, very skilled rider. And I don't wanna die. Then once I've been on it, I can decide what I can take on next time. And the KTM 1090 is just fine for me on it. This little segment is for Dennis's friends who are coming out to the gathering this year. Welcome! Look at the crazy stuff that Dennis bought. So close, hey? That's tiring. Huh? How you doing? It's tiring, hey?
Yeah.
Oh, what have I done? I'm a bad friend. Bad. Oh yeah, I remember this. Okay, I'm just gonna do it. I'm just gonna go, man. I'm just gonna go. I'm glad you didn't wipe out, especially because I would have missed it on camera. That would have been terrible. It's a bad place to get on my bike, so let's do the rolling start thing. I'm crying. It's crazy.
ride it up there.
Please fun. Way to go, buddy.
You know what?
Dude's got skills. Just a little rusty. Taking a few years off.
Been hanging with the wrong crowd. Crowd to ride stuff is a little bit easier. Take this first dump. I fall down. I've had a little incident here. See that guy? It's touching. So, brake off, brake on. That's unacceptable. So this rot weather light, if I pull that off, it'll have clearance and we'll be rolling again. Let's hope I have the proper wrench. Otherwise we're gonna be using the rock tool and smashing that all out. Dennis is about to go up the big hill and he's just got to remember to smile, right? I'm gonna get started on that. I had to move this thing, so we had to take this all apart. Put it back together again. We've got clearance. And I just want to hear him make it to the top. That's all that matters right now. Good. Okay, it's getting closer. Come on, Mongo. It's time. Okay, I had a little energy cookie. Bike's in good shape again. Nice grass. Okay, look ahead. Make it a plan. I see it. We're going to have a plan for the truck. Give me a fist bump. Nicely done. Enjoy the scenery, guys. Look ahead and make a plan. Should be able to basically come to a stop, survey, make a plan, and go. And score, Dennis and I have each had one off. He broke his bark buster, which is plastic. I bit my aluminum bark buster. We're tied. Okay. Look ahead. Roll through it. Kick in his path. Maybe get off the binders and let her go. Look at the little birds on the trail. Oh, I barely revved my engine the entire day. Rode out here, it's one of those trails. You sure don't need a 1000cc bike for this, do ya? Why would you ride a 1000cc bike on a trail like this? Well, it's fun. What am I going to say? It's more fun than riding a 500cc bike on here. Hey, if you can do it, it's more fun.
if you don't have the skills, the endurance, or whatever yet, and I say yet, then it's not going to be as much fun. This is a lively ride, guys. And that's why I think the 1200 is going to be even more fun. I'm going to have a real sense of accomplishment if I can get the 1200 through here without too many problems. One of the big differences on that bike, I can touch the ground flat foot full speed. That's it for the double track. We've made it out to the brand new haul road. It's like this or better the rest of the way out. We survived. Fun ride. Very challenging for Dennis. Very challenging for me on this bike. It was just the right amount of adventure for me. Maybe a little bit more than what Dennis wanted to sign up for, but he came through the other side. He's going to be pretty proud of himself. He's proud of the way he handled himself and how he rode. Good stuff, man. Okay. Take a look around, folks. This burnt earlier this year, right down to the rocks. Not anything left in there. Little flecks of green coming back. Next spring it'll be real pretty in here. There'll be fireweed everywhere. Still a lot of burnt sticks standing, but that's what it looks like. If you're not from an area like this, well, we get to see fires all the time, unfortunately. But it is pretty cool. I didn't get to hear my engine much, so. That's what the 1090 does really well. Get up and go. Breaks too.